Welcome back. I am Dr. Lee's AI speaking assistant in practical pain management. In the streaming in the ultrasound room, I will show you some basic ultrasound practical anatomies and ultrasound guided interventional procedures. I will share the procedure for relieving the postoperative pain after the carpal tunnel release operation. She received the surgical carpal tunnel release 2 years ago. The tinglings of the entire palm and fingers are the main symptom. She felt the pain was extending proximally into the shoulder when the pain was intense. The pain became worse after COVID-19 infection 1 month ago. The X-ray shows a simple disc degeneration at the cervical C5-6 spine. My ultrasound scan showed a swollen median nerve with internal homogeneous, low echogenicity proximal to the resected transverse carpal ligament. In addition, the median nerve is well encapsulated with an echogenic halo. There is an abrupt focal narrowing of the nerve in the carpal tunnel. I believe the focal narrowing resulted from scar formation at the operation site. So, I want to release the scar with hydrodissection and steroids. I may need multiple procedures to accomplish the decompression. I will see you in the operation room. My staff will explain the procedure details. Now, she is in the surgical room receiving preparation for the hand procedure. The patient is supine with palm up. For the simple injection technique, there are other positions. But, I always approach from the radial side for the release of the carpal tunnel ligament and hydrodissect the median nerve. You can watch the surgical scar on the wrist. Let me begin. It will sting. I will anesthetize the skin and subcutaneous tissue before the hydrodissecting procedure. The surgical site is innervated by the palmar cutaneous branch of the median nerve, and the nerve arises from the median nerve main trunk, proximal to the wrist crease. Therefore, if I block the proximal region, I can anesthetize the whole area, including the distal area. Do you feel a tingling sensation at all the fingers? I must frequently put enough aseptic gel on the wrist for ultrasound visualization. I will use a 17 to 18 gauge needle to release the transverse carpal ligament. But I will use a 25 gauge 1.5 inch needle for the simple hydrodissection before the releasing procedure. Ouch! I forgot to evacuate all the air from the syringe. So I will remove the air from the fluid. I will separate the median nerve from the covering tissue using fluid and hydraulic pressure. The fluid contains 1 milliliter of dexamethasone palmitate and 750 units of hyaluronidase. Next, I will connect the syringe to the 18-gauge needle. I bent the needle tip to use the blade to release the scar tissue. I always pay attention to the direction of the needle tip and watch out not to harm the median nerve. Usually, the contact feeling of the hard tissue becomes soft while repeatedly fenestration of the scar or thick transverse carpal ligament. After mechanical release, I infiltrate the 20 mg of triamcinolone in the scar to prevent reattachment or regrowth. I appreciate your cooperation. Please remember to stretch your wrist repeatedly. Thank you for watching. See you in the following videos.